Hello friends, myself Amit Belekar welcomes you to my channel Tips and Tricks by AMB, and today we have to discuss about co-trimoxazole. After going through this video, the learner will be able to describe co-trimoxazole, describe advantages of combining sulphonamide with trimethoprim, and describe reason behind combining trimethoprim preferably with sulphamethoxazole. So first we have to discuss about what is co-trimoxazole. Co-trimoxazole is a combination of sulphonamide with trimethoprim. This combination is used effectively for the treatment of most of the infections. These two drugs have synergistic effect in inhibiting the bacterial growth. So we have to discuss why sulphonamide is combined with trimethoprim. We know that folic acid is essential for bacterial growth, which is synthesized from para-aminobenzoic acid, which is called as PABA. Folic acid is synthesized from PABA with the help of an enzyme which is called as folic acid synthetase enzyme. Folic acid is then further converted into dihydrofolic acid with the help of folic acid reductase enzyme. Further, this dihydrofolic acid is converted into tetrahydrofolic acid with the help of dihydrofolate reductase enzyme. Now, tetrahydrofolic acid, which is formed, it is responsible for the formation of purine and pyrimidine bases, which are required for RNA and DNA synthesis. So folic acid and then tetrahydrofolic acid is very important for bacterial growth. Sulphonamides are having structural similarity with PABA, that is para-aminobenzoic acid, and as these are having structural similarity with PABA, they competitively inhibit bacterial folic acid synthetase enzyme, and they prevent the conversion of PABA into folic acid and thus interferes the bacterial growth. Thus, sulfonamides are bacteriostatic in action. Trimethoprim prevents the subsequent step, that is conversion of dihydrofolic acid to tetrahydrofolic acid, by competitively inhibiting dihydrofolate reductase enzyme, which is responsible for formation of tetrahydrofolic acid. Thus, co-trimoxazole, that is the combination of sulfonamide and trimethoprim, prevents conversion of PABA into purines and pyrimidine bases by competitively blocking subsequent steps involved in the formation of purine and pyrimidine bases. These purine and pyrimidine bases, as we discussed, these are responsible for the formation of RNA and DNA of the bacteria. That's why these are very useful for bacterial growth. So if we use sulfonamide individually and trimethoprim individually, both these drugs individually act as bacteriostatic in nature. But when we use these drugs in combination, sulfonamide with trimethoprim, these two drugs in combination, which is called as co-trimoxazole, these drugs now act as bactericidal in nature. So there is increase in the efficiency of these drugs by combining. So we can get synergistic effect. We can say that we can get potentiation effect bacteriostatic drug, it is converted into the bactericidal drug. So that effect we achieve after the combination. That's why sulfonamides are combined with trimethoprim. Now next part we have to discuss, that is trimethoprim is combined preferably with sulphamethoxazole in from the class of sulfonamides. So there are several sulfonamides available. Out of that, trimethoprim is combined preferably with sulfamethoxazole. Why this combination or that sulfamethoxazole is preferred to get combined with the trimethoprim? So there are some reasons. Both trimethoprim and sulfamethoxazole are well absorbed from gastrointestinal tract. That is one of the important reason behind combination. Next reason is that about 75% of trimethoprim and about 65% of sulfamethoxazole is bound to plasma protein. So plasma protein binding and distribution is also similar, we can say. Next reason, that is up to 60% of trimethoprim and 25 to 50% of the sulfamethoxazole is excreted through the urine. So here is again somewhat similarity we are doing in the excretion of drug. And because of that, half-life of these two drugs, both the drugs are same, that is about 9 to 10 hours. So half-life is same, and because of that, their absorption pattern is same, their distribution pattern is same. So it is very good combination. We can space the doses of this combination very easily because their half-life is same. So frequency of administration, there is no problem. Thus these two drugs can be combined, or preferably sulfamethoxazole is combined with the trimethoprim because of these similarities which they are having. So now it is time to summarize. We had in this video, we had discussed about advantages of combining sulfonamides with trimethoprim. Also we had discussed why trimethoprim is combined preferably with sulfamethoxazole. So thank you for listening patiently. If you have any queries, you can contact me on my mail address which is given below. If you want to watch more such videos, you can like and subscribe my channel Tips and Tricks by AMB. Thank you once again.